guys, it's Lindsay Ann and welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing another Closet Essentials video and you already know what season it is. And despite the fact that I'm mildly sweating my balls out right now, we are gonna talk about jackets and sweaters and boots. Honestly, now moving to LA, I feel like fall is definitely like one of the things I miss the most about living in a place where there's seasons. And the beginning of fall literally just like marks like the beginning of the holiday season, I feel. It's just such a joyous time. But to get into the spooky season spirit, I bought myself a little pumpkin from Trader Joe's. His name is Ted. Say hi to Ted.
Hi.
And we're really just gonna use him as a mascot for this video. Anyways, as always, my fall essentials just consist of just basic pieces to have in your wardrobe for this season and just specific things to look out for if you want to stay more on trend and just basically what the people are wearing for fall 2021. And without further ado, let's get started. So for this fall, we're really just returning to basics because the Y2K trend is over, the indie trend is over, quarantine is basically just a different alternate universe at this point. And now we're returning to the normal world where we have to work and we can't just prance around in low-waisted jeans and hot pink tube tops around our house and take pictures, you know? So for this fall, I would classify like the main trend as like business casual, 90s model off duty, just really neutral colors, almost with a preppy edge to it, and overall just some like really basic pieces that you probably already have in your closet. So starting off, we have a white tank top. This is literally like, I feel like the fundamental of everyone's closet, just a plain white tank top. But you can definitely play around with like the fit, the cutouts, to just emphasize and differentiate your style a little bit more. So for example, I got this Zara white tank top, but has pretty like deep armpit holes, if that makes sense. Like we got some C curves going on here. I feel like this top definitely just makes you stand out a little bit more, but while still keeping like really basic and neutral pieces. Up next, we have white button downs. And this has honestly been a staple in my closet since sophomore year of high school, because that's when I first started getting into fashion. And I would prance around school with like my dad's Costco oversized button downs. And I would tuck it into these like black skinny jeans. And you know, I would be taking some pictures in my school bathroom thinking I was the shit, and you know, things haven't changed. I actually stole this from my mom's closet, but this is just a white button down from Loft, and I really like this one because it's not just like the cotton or linen ones. This is a bit of a sheer material, and it has this like lace detail on the collar, which I think is really, really cute. How I wear this top specifically is I get those like blouse clips that you can get just on Amazon, and I just pin it in the back, so it has more of a tighter fit and it's like more form-fitting. And I think that this definitely goes with the whole preppy vibe and looks really, really cute with just like a simple skirt or like knee-high boots. But definitely also play around with the fit of these like white shirts, because there's just so many avenues, routes that you can take. Remember, it's about the journey, not the destination. But of course, I'll always love just like a plain white linen button down. This just works so well. And my new favorite way to wear this is like underneath blazers, just to have like unbuttoned and a tank top underneath. So you can just show a little bit of like this like white collar and this like white detail. I think that's like really, really chic. And I don't know, just like it brings out a little bit more of like a white accent. Next up, we got my favorite trend from this season, which is, can you already guess it? It's the blazer. The only thing that I wear to school these days is just a blazer. But I recently got these two blazers from ASOS and I really like the fit of them. They're like an oversized baggy fit. And I think that these like oversized blazers are such a huge part of this like fall trend cycle, because it definitely goes in with the whole like business casual 90s model off duty type of vibe. And it's just so simple and basic to throw on, especially like if you live in a warmer climate. This is like a lot lighter than like a leather jacket or a coat. And you know, you can still get some like fall vibes, fall energy from this even without sweating to death. An additional blazer fit is a crop blazer. I think that this looks so good with any like going out outfit or just like a night out with the girls, because It's cropped, so you get less of that like casual fit. It's more fitted. It's more of like a girl boss gatekeep gaslight moment. And I got mine from Zara, and I really like their crop blazer collection there because they have a lot of colors and the fit is so nice. So it's like the perfect thing to throw on over like a dress or like a going out outfit. And of course, we can't forget the blazer that started it all, the leather blazer. And these leather jackets definitely aren't going away anytime soon. I have definitely invested a few coins into curating the perfect leather jacket. These two are my favorite because this first one is just such a nice fit. Like, I got so lucky. I talked about this in my fall haul, but I literally thrifted this. It was probably like $35, which is such a steal for a leather jacket like this. It's such good quality. Like, I just can't talk about it enough. Like, this jacket has gotten so much more praise, so much more validation than I ever had my whole entire life. Like, this jacket is really just like the star of the show. I also really love colored leather jackets because I feel like it definitely adds like a pop of color. But if you want to stay more on trend, definitely try to find a more neutral or toned down type of color rather than like a bright or neon pink pastel blue. More muted, more seasonal, fall energy. Just remember, fall energy. Another basic that is coming back in full force is the trench coat. The last time that I owned a trench coat was when I was 9. And if I remember so distinctly, my mom, my grandma, and I, we went to Kohl's and we bought this like trench coat for my sister and I to share. It was like this tan trench coat, but it had like a pink lining on the inside. So I felt so cool. So I would always like basically flash people with my pink lining, and I would wear it to Chinese school every single Saturday. My weekends as like a kid was actually so intense for no reason. Like, I had Chinese school, I had piano lessons, I had drawing lessons, and I had like fucking like Kumon and some shit. Kids do too much. If you're going through that right now, things will get better, I promise you. Just tell yourself that this is building character. And the phrase that I think goes best with trench coats is, the longer the better. Let's talk about shoes, because I don't think I've been more excited about shoes this whole year until now, because I got these babies, knee-high boots. Everyone and their moms and their dads and their grandmas and grandpas and weird uncles are gonna be wearing knee-high boots this season. It's the new Docs, okay? I'm telling you this right now. Everyone is going to be wearing these goddamn knee-high boots, and get them quick because they are selling out. I was able to get a pair from ASOS. Is it ASOS? ASOS? I feel like I hear it both ways. I'm gonna go with ASOS. I got these from ASOS, but I got them a size like too big because they didn't have my size. So I kind of just like stomp around with them, like very awkwardly. But you know, they're still cute. I don't have regrets. And I feel like the best way to wear these type of boots is with skirts, because if you wear them with pants, you just look like a little kid in rain boots. So if you wear it with like a skirt, you know, you show like a little bit of skin, your kneecap. Also, I was literally just talking about this with my friend the other day. Are your guys' kneecaps hairy? I feel like there's certain areas on your body where hair grows that is just so weird. Like, why are my kneecaps hairy? But before we go on to the next trend, I want to say thank you to the sponsor of today's video, Curology. If you guys don't already know, Curology is a skincare brand that delivers customized skincare to you. I recently started the free trial and my products came, so I want to let you guys know my first impressions are. First of all, my skincare routine has just become so easy and simple now because they sent me a cleanser, a moisturizer, and a customized cream. Before, I would have so many random steps in my skincare routine, but now by following this, it's just so much easier. And honestly, after using it for like about a week now, I feel like my skin has improved already, because my main problem areas was that it was really, really dry and I was like breaking out. And this cream honestly helps so much with that because it's really, really thick. And I also really like the cleanser and moisturizer too, because it's just so like light and gentle on the skin. So I really have no complaints. I'm gonna try them out for a couple more weeks to see if anything changes, but I just wanted to give you guys a little progress update on how my Curology journey is going. Another good option is like these, I don't even know, like mid-calf boots. Like, maybe you've been working out, you know, you want to show off your hard work and progress, so you don't want to cover up all your calves. This is the perfect option for you. I can't relate to that statement because I have not worked out in about a year. So, knee-high boots for me. let's talk about sneakers. And for this season, white sneakers are definitely still in, but if you're looking for a new pair of sneakers, or maybe you just have like some old beaters that you just want to throw away, I highly suggest New Balance. I love all of their shoes, but the trendiest shoe right now for New Balance are these gray ones. I'll put the name up here, but they're pretty pricey, so it's definitely like a splurge. But I think that this gray color is really, really nice. It definitely goes in with like the whole neutral aesthetic for this fall. And of course, we can't forget our Docs. This was the trend of every teenage girl last year. We're not gonna be throwing these away anytime soon because the amount of blisters, the amount of times I had to pull up my sock for this shoe, like, I feel like I've just grown a connection to it. So let's talk about pants now, because high-waisted pants are back, at least for me, because I think I'm just, high-waisted pants are so much more practical. I feel more confident in them. Like, I went through the whole low-waisted phase and it was good. A lot of the fits I still think were pretty fire, but you know, just for practicality, I feel like high-waisted pants are superior, unfortunately. Definitely stock up on your jeans. I'm wearing these like dark wash ones that I really, really like right now because they definitely give me that like 90s nostalgia vibes. And these jeans are like the only thing that I wear to school, so it's just really easy to just grab and go. Dickies. Need I say more? Literally everyone is wearing them right now. I feel like right now people are definitely wearing Dickies as like a more casual trouser vibe, and I love it. They're a really cheap and affordable option. They're only like $30 on the website right now, but definitely I'll look for restocks because they're like all selling out. I got these in a size 28 and they fit pretty nicely, but I feel like I should have sized up a little bit, just have like a looser fit, because right now if it's interesting, like I don't mind it, I wouldn't return it, but I feel like a size bigger wouldn't hurt. Of course, we got trousers, just your basic pair of like work pants. But if you want to make it more casual, definitely try like a low-waisted fit. I think that those type of pants are like really, really sexy and gives like a whole like business casual energy, just like a bit of a facelift, you know? And leather pants for fall. It's a match made in heaven, really. Last year, Aritzia's like Melina, one of their leather pants went viral and everyone bought them. But there's a lot of other like more affordable options for leather pants as well, especially like faux leather pants if you're interested in that. And I got this pair from Princess Polly, and you know, I just really like the fit. Just try finding yourself like a straight fit leather pants, and it just goes so well and elevates like all your outfits. Some more trends I want to talk about is, one is varsity jackets. I've been seeing these like jackets everywhere. They remind me of like the racer jackets that were really, really popular over the past year, but now they're like varsity jackets. And I know House of Sunny has like a whole collection with these varsity jackets. They definitely give me like a cool girl streetwear energy. You can buy them online, but I'm sure that if you pray to the thrifting gods, you'll be able to find a good one for a reasonable price when you're at like a thrift store or something. And of course, sweaters, another basic for bodily warmth. I've been seeing so many like oversized, boxy sweaters with more like neutral colors. And I feel like it pairs so well with like a trench coat or a blazer over it. But that is all the closet essentials that I have for this fall season. I really hope that you guys enjoy this video and maybe got a little bit of inspiration, just an idea of what you want your wardrobe to look like for this fall. But I really hope that you guys have an amazing rest of your day. Stay safe, and as always, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.